Hello students, I welcome everyone to the next session, class 9 mathematics, chapter 2 polynomials, exercise 2.5. This exercise based on identities. Already we know few identities. Another some more identities we learn from this exercise. These are the identities we are going to use in this exercise. Now we move on to exercise 2.5. First question, use suitable identities to find the following products. Here 5 subdivisions are the few subdivision. I'll do it for you. First subdivision, x plus 4 into x plus 10. Here we are going to use the identity as x plus a into x plus b. That is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. In the given question, a value as 4, b value as 10. Now we have to apply in the identity, that is x square plus 4 plus 10 into x plus 4 into 10. So the answer is x square plus 14x plus 40. Second subdivision, x plus 8 into x minus 10. Here we are going to apply the same identity, x plus a into x plus b, that is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Here a value we are going to take as 8, b value as minus 10. Now we have to apply the in the identity, that is x square plus 8 plus minus 10 into x plus 8 into minus 10, that is x square plus 8 minus 10 into x minus 80. The answer is x square minus 2x minus 80. Fourth subdivision, y square plus 3 by 2 into y square minus 3 by 2. Here we are going to use the identity as x plus y into x minus y, that is x square minus y square. In the place of x, we have to take y square, and in the place of y, we'll take 3 by 2. Now we'll apply in the identity y square plus 3 by 2 into y square minus 3 by 2. Next, y square the whole square minus 3 by 2 the whole square. So the answer is y power 4 minus 9 by 4. Second question, evaluate the following products without multiplying directly. First subdivision, 103 into 107. First we can split this into 100 plus 3 into 100 plus 7. We are going to use the identity as x plus a into x plus b, that is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Here in the place of x 100, in the place of a 3, and in the place of b 7. Now we'll apply in this identity, that is 100 square plus 3 plus 7 into 100 plus 3 into 7. Next, 10,000 plus 10 into 100 plus 21. Next, 10,000 plus 1,000 plus 21. So we'll get the answer as 11,021. Second subdivision, 95 into 96. First we have to split this as 100 minus 5 into 100 minus 4. Now we have to use the identity x plus a into x plus b, that is x square plus a plus b into x plus ab. Here x value as 100, a value as minus 5, and b value as minus 4. Now we have to apply in this identity, that is 100 square plus minus 5 minus 4 into 100 plus minus 5 into minus 4, that is 10,000 minus 900 plus 20. We'll get the answer as 9,120. Third subdivision, 104 into 96. First we have to split this as 100 plus 4 into 100 minus 4. Here we are going to use the identity as a plus b into a minus b, that is a square minus b square. Here a value as 100, b value as 4. Now we have to apply in this identity, that is 100 square minus 4 square, that is 10,000 minus 16. We'll get the answer as 9,984. Third question, factorize the following using appropriate identities. First subdivision, 9x square plus 6xy plus y square. Here we are going to use the identity as a square plus 2ab plus b square, that is a plus b the whole square. Here a square is 9x square, so a value as 3x, and the b square is y square, and the b value is y. Now we have to apply in this identity, that is 3x the whole square plus 2 into 3x into y plus y square. square. So the answer is 3x plus y the whole square. So it is in the form of a plus b the whole square. Second subdivision, 4y square minus 4y plus 1. Here a square is 4y square and the a value as 2y. B square is 1 square and the b value as 1. Here we are going to use the identity as a square minus 2ab plus b square, that is a minus b the whole square. Now we have to apply in the identity, that is 2y the whole square minus 2 into 2y into 1 plus 1 square. So the answer is 2y minus 1 the whole square. Third subdivision, x square minus y square by 100. Here we are going to use the identity as a square minus b square, that is a plus b into a minus b. Now we can write this as x square minus y by 10 the whole square. Now we apply in the identity, that is x plus y by 10 into x minus y by 10. Fourth question, expand each of the following using suitable identities. Here 6 subdivisions are there. I'll do it 3 subdivision for you. First subdivision, x plus 2y plus 4z the whole square. Here we are going to use the identity as a plus b plus c the whole square. That is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Here a value as x, b value as 2y and c value as 4z. Now we are going to apply in this identity, that is x square plus 2y the whole square plus 4z the whole square plus 2 into x into 2y plus 2 into 2y into 4z plus 2 into 4z into x. So the final answer is x square plus 4y square plus 16z square plus 4xy plus 16yz plus 8xz. Fifth subdivision, minus 2x plus 5y minus 3z the whole square. We are going to use the same identity, that is a plus b plus c the whole square, that is a square plus b square plus c square plus 2ab plus 2bc plus 2ca. Here a value as minus 2x, b value as 5y and c value as minus 3z. Now we are going to apply in this identity, that is minus 2x the whole square plus 5y the whole square plus minus 3z the whole square plus 2 into minus 2x into 5y plus 2 into 5y into minus 3z plus 2 into minus 3z into minus 2x. So the final answer is 4x square plus 25y square plus 9z square minus 20xy minus 30yz plus 12xz. Sixth subdivision, 1 by 4a minus 1 by 2b plus 1 the whole square. Here we are going to use the same identity, that is a plus b plus c the whole square. Here a value as a by 4 and b value as minus b by 2 and c value as 1. Now we apply in this identity, we'll get the answer as a square by 16 plus b square by 4 plus 1 minus ab by 4 minus b plus a by 2. I hope you understand this session. Thank you, students.